In a shocking discovery, astronomers have found what seems to be an exact replica of the Milky Way in the outer reaches of the universe. This has sparked debates about parallel universes and the multiverse theory among the scientific community. Let's take a closer look. The Milky Way is a barred spiral galaxy around 13.6 billion years old, with large pivoting arms stretching out across the cosmos. Our home galaxy's disk is about 100,000 light-years in diameter and just 1,000 light-years thick, according to Las Cumbres Observatory. Just as Earth orbits the Sun, the solar system orbits the center of the Milky Way. Despite hurtling through space at speeds of around 515,000 miles per hour, our solar system takes approximately 250 million years to complete a single revolution, according to Interesting Engineering. The last time our planet was in this position, dinosaurs were just emerging, and mammals were yet to evolve. If the center of the Milky Way were a city, we would be living in suburbia, about 25,000 to 30,000 light years from the city center. Life in the outskirts is good. We find ourselves nestled in one of the smaller neighborhoods, the Orion Cygnus arm, sandwiched between larger Perseus and Carina Sagittarius arms. If we were to travel inwards towards the city center, we would find the Scutum Centaurus and the Norma arms. On a clear night, void of light pollution, we can catch a glimpse of the bright lights of the galactic city streaking across the night sky. Our window into the universe, this milky white band of stars, dust, and gas, is where our galaxy gets its name. Lying at the very heart of the Milky Way is a supermassive black hole called Sagittarius A**. About 4 million times the mass of the Sun, this beast consumes anything that strays too close, gorging on an ample supply of stellar material, enabling it to grow into a giant. In 2022, we imaged this glutton at the core of our galaxy for the very first time through an innovative technique allowing us to view the shadow of the black hole. According to the American Museum of Natural History, our galactic home is called the Milky Way after its apparent milky white appearance as it stretches across the night sky. In Greek mythology, this milky band appeared because the goddess Hera sprayed milk across the sky. Around the world, the Milky Way is known by different names. For example, in China, it is called the Silver River, and in the Kalahari Desert in South Africa, it's called the Backbone of Night. We are constantly building on our wealth of knowledge of the Milky Way, though up until relatively recently, astronomers believed that all the stars in the sky belong to our galaxy. The Great Debate in 1920 saw astronomers Herbert Curtis and Harlow Shapley argue the scale of the universe and the prospect of island universes, according to the National Academy of Sciences. On one side of the debate, Shapley believed the Milky Way was much larger than previous estimates and that we weren't at the center. He also claimed that spiral nebulae, such as Andromeda, were a part of the Milky Way. On the other side of the debate, Curtis did not dispute Shapley's claims of a far larger Milky Way. He did, however, argue that there were large island universes such as Andromeda that lay beyond the boundaries of the Milky Way. The dispute was resolved when Edwin Hubble's measurements of Cepheid variable stars proved Andromeda was located far outside the Milky Way. Modern estimates suggest the Andromeda Galaxy, our nearest galactic neighbor, is 2.5 million light-years away. More recently, astronomers have been trying to figure out what type of galaxy the Milky Way is. Our best estimates these days suggest that it is a barred spiral, meaning that there is a bar structure across the center. Astronomers can estimate the shape of the Milky Way by looking at its population of stars, as well as their movements across the sky. We know now that the Milky Way resides within the local group of galaxies, made up of over 30 galaxies including Andromeda, Triangulum, and Leo 1, to name but a few. It turns out that it's pretty good to know who your neighbors are, as they may be closer than you think. The Milky Way is currently hurtling towards Andromeda at 250,000 miles per hour. Though there is no need to worry just yet, this crash of cosmic proportions is not due for another 4 billion years. NASA and other space entities have been observing distant galaxy collisions for decades now to get a sense of what we might be facing when Andromeda and the Milky Way collide. The short story is, there is little to worry about, The longer tale is about the process and is an interesting one as it shows how galaxies may evolve. It was believed that the Milky Way is a unique galaxy unlike any other in the universe, but this may all change thanks to the multiverse theory. Parallel universes are no longer just a feature of a good sci-fi story. There are now some scientific theories that support the idea of parallel universes beyond our own. Our universe is unimaginably big. Hundreds of billions, if not trillions, of galaxies spinning through space, each containing billions or trillions of stars. Some researchers studying models of the universe speculate that the universe's diameter could be 7 billion light years across. Others think it could be infinite. But is it all that's out there? Science fiction loves the idea of a parallel universe and the thought that we may be living just one of an infinite number of possible lives. The scientific theory explores, and in some cases supports, the case for universes outside, parallel to, or distant from, but mirroring our own. Multiverses and parallel worlds are often argued in the context of other major scientific concepts like the Big Bang, string theory, and quantum mechanics. Around 13.7 billion years ago, everything we know of was an infinitesimal singularity. Then, according to the Big Bang theory, it burst into action, inflating faster than the speed of light in all directions for a tiny fraction of a second. In fact, before hardly any time had passed, the universe had exploded outward in a process called cosmic inflation. And that's all before the actual expansion of matter that we usually think of as the Big Bang itself, which was a consequence of all this inflation. As the inflation slowed, a flood of matter and radiation appeared, creating the classic Big Bang fireball, and began to form the atoms, molecules, stars, and galaxies that populate the vastness of space that surrounds us. That mysterious process of inflation and the Big Bang have convinced some researchers that multiple universes are possible or even very likely. According to theoretical physicist Alexander Vilenkin of Tufts University in Massachusetts, inflation didn't end everywhere at the same time. While it ended for everything that we can detect from Earth 13.8 billion years ago, cosmic inflation continues in other places. This is called the theory of eternal inflation. And as inflation ends in a particular place, a new bubble universe forms. Those bubble universes can't contact each other because they continue to expand indefinitely. If we were to set off for the edge of our bubble, where it might butt up against the next bubble universe over, we'd never reach it because the edge is zipping away from us faster than the speed of light and faster than we could ever travel. But even if we could reach the next bubble, according to eternal inflation, our familiar universe, with its physical constants and habitable conditions, could be different from the hypothetical bubble universe next to our own. The Lincoln's explanation implies that in some of the infinite bubble universes outside our own, there could be other intelligent observers. But in every instant that passes, we get farther away from them and we will never intersect. Some researchers base their ideas of parallel universes on quantum mechanics, the mathematical description of subatomic particles. In quantum mechanics, multiple states of existence for tiny particles are all possible at the same time. A wave function encapsulates all of these possibilities. However, when we look, we only ever observe one of the possibilities. According to the Copenhagen interpretation of quantum mechanics, as described by the Stanford Encyclopedia of Philosophy, we observe an outcome when the wave function collapses into a single reality. But the many worlds theory proposes instead that every time one state or outcome is observed, there is another world in which a different quantum outcome becomes reality. This is a branching arrangement in which, instant by instant, our perceived universe branches into near infinite alternatives. Those alternate universes are completely separate and unable to intersect, so while there may be uncountable versions of you living a life that's slightly or wildly different from your life in this world, you'd never know it. Some physicists believe in a flatter version of multiple universes. That is, if the universe that we live in goes on forever, there are only so many ways that the building blocks of matter can arrange themselves as they assemble across infinite space. Eventually, any finite number of particle types must repeat a particular arrangement. Hypothetically, in a big enough space, those particles must repeat arrangements as large as entire solar systems and galaxies. So your entire life might be repeated elsewhere in the universe, down to what you ate for breakfast yesterday. At least, that's the theory. A recent study has brought forward a new possibility that may point toward the existence of a mirror universe. In a relatively recent addition to the pantheon of multiverse theories, researchers from the Perimeter Institute for Theoretical Physics in Waterloo, Ontario, have proposed that the universe began at the Big Bang, and on the opposite side of the Big Bang timeline, stretching backward in time, a universe once existed that was the exact mirror image of our own. Instead of saying there was a different universe before the Bang, some scientists believe that the universe before the Bang is, in some sense, an image of the universe after the Bang. That means everything, protons, electrons, even actions like cracking an egg, would be reversed. Antiprotons and positively charged electrons would make up atoms, while eggs would uncrack and make their way back inside chickens. Eventually, that universe would shrink down, presumably to a singularity, before expanding out into our universe. Seen another way, both universes were created at the Big Bang and exploded simultaneously backward and forward in time. This dichotomy allows for some creative explanations for problems that have stumped physicists for years. For one, it would make the first second of the universe fairly simple, removing the necessity for the bizarre multiverses and dimensions experts have used for three decades to explain some of the stickier aspects of quantum physics and the Standard Model, which describes the zoo of subatomic particles that make up our universe. This means that somewhere out there, there is an exact mirror image of the Milky Way, down to the very last detail. The scientists say this new theory grew out of a dissatisfaction with the bizarre add-ons proposed by physicists in recent years. Turok himself helped develop such explanations, but felt a deep desire for a simple explanation of the universe and the Big Bang. They also say this new theory has the benefit of being testable, which will be crucial in winning over doubters. The Canadian team understands this, and they'll be using the model to propose measurable, testable elements to see if they are correct. For instance, their model predicts the lightest neutrino should be devoid of mass altogether. If they are right, it might reshape how we see the universe. If you like this video, you may also enjoy this one, which talks about interstellar objects entering into our solar system. Do you think the multiverse theory could be real? Please share your thoughts in the comment section below.